Hello, here is the Ryzen 3600 I received this morning from Saks. That's WeBuy. Came in a nice bit of cardboard and a nice clamshell plastic, but the pins were bent. At least two corners had bent pins. Six pins I had to re-bent. They weren't bent badly, but I can't believe it ever fit in a socket. And I wanted to try the mechanical pencil trick. I've got a few mechanical pencils lying around. Started off with my regular go-to mechanical pencil. It's often used, as you can see by the condition of it. It's 0.7mm, I think. There's just no markings left on it. It's 0.7mm. I checked the spare leads. Billions of them. They're quite expensive, these pencils. It's good to get some use out of them at long last. Here you can see there's a lot of play with a 0.7mm pencil. You don't feel any resistance when you're bending the pins, so play isn't a good thing. If I had a tighter fit, I could see how the pin was bent, because the whole pencil becomes an extension of it. So I had a look through my collection and found a 0.5, which I gave that a go. It's still too loose. I have a Mars Micro 77503 here. The 03 means it's a 0.3mm pencil. I don't have any spare leads for it. It's tiny, I hardly ever use it, as you can see by how good a condition it's in. Before I can use it to bend any pins, I have to get the lead out of the hole, else it's clamped in and I risk bending a pin, or not even attaching to a pin. But I'm going to have to hold my thumb on the rubber at the end and push it onto a pin to push the lead back. Alternatively, I could just click it all the way out, but that's wear on the clicker. And then I've got a half-eaten lead to feed back in at the rubber end. So instead I'm trying to latch it onto a pin, and it's really fiddly at 0.3mm. I mean, I've got pretty stable hands, I'm not an alky or anything. And eventually I settled on this solution where I use my finger at the side, and that just adds enough stability if I've got something not moving to line it up against. So that got the lead back in, and now I've got to bend a few pins back. The whole procedure took about 10 minutes, I'm going to say, for 6 pins. I'm going to speed it up because it's not terribly interesting. You just have to make sure that the pencil is straight once you've got it on. And that's assuming it's a good fit, otherwise you've got to overcompensate if you've got a loose one. But this is a 3600, and I'm using a 0.3mm pencil. I will check that and correct myself if I'm wrong. It's really hard to see it in the video that they're straight, but as the photos at the beginning show, there were definitely some bent pins to begin with. I don't know how it fit in the socket for them to test it. The worst bend was about 5 degrees, so at the end they were out by about 3 pin widths. I'll show it going in the socket at the end, and you'll see that there's quite a lot of play once it's in. Or maybe you won't see it, but I saw it. I'll try and show it. It's quite a lot of play once it's in, so maybe they tested it. Same procedure on each of the pins. You just put the empty shell around it, and that ensures that you're pressing at the far end of the pin. And you've also got a pivot at the base, so you're not going to introduce more kinks. You're just going to bend it straight, assuming there weren't any kinks to begin with. Even then, it's good to be able to slide a cylinder right over as a template. The moment of truth, let's see if it sits in the socket. It darts and give it a little wiggle, and yeah, it's definitely in. Give it some more wiggle because, well, I didn't try it before, I don't know what a negative result looked like. A bit of fluff on it. I'll paste that and test it later.